Hi friends, I'm Crystal Pridmore. I'm the president-elect for the San Diego chapter of the American Orchestral Work Association, and I'm an elementary music teacher like all of you. I work here in San Diego, California. I teach kindergarten through sixth grade music. I am also married to and partners with, in business, with a professional videographer. We have been videoing and photographing weddings for 13 years, and I wanted to help all of you in this weird situation where we suddenly find ourselves going from being orchestral work teachers working with children in person to being asked to move some version of our content online. I feel that it's very important for me to be making these videos to share with my students. This whole situation is like nothing I have ever experienced, and I know many of us are feeling very unstable right now. The importance of what we do face-to-face with kids is so vital in their development. We help make well-rounded, whole, connected human beings, and the magic that we make together in the music room is irreplaceable. I work at a Title I school, and a lot of my kids have unstable home situations, and we usually try to do things to set the stage to have a school break where they know they are loved, they are cared for, they have things to take home with them, and things to look forward to when they come back. And here we are in this situation where a lot of their concerts that they were looking forward to have been canceled. Their time together in music class has been canceled, and we were not planning on it. And I don't know about you, but I had a really hard time saying goodbye to my children. So I feel that it is extremely important for me to put something online for them to have the comfort of their music teacher and a little bit of familiarity in this time of uncertainty. So I want to help all of you do that same thing. I will be beginning and ending all of my videos to my students with the acknowledgement that this is a strange time and that it's normal for them to be feeling a little bit anxious and a little bit scared, but that I care about them and that I am sending some love to them and that I can't wait for us to be together again and that we will talk about our feelings and talk about the things that we did and learned during the COVID-19 crisis. So I'm hoping that you can do the same. These videos are not going to be a replacement for in-person music class, and anybody who has walked into my classroom and seen me interact with my students will know that. And I am confident that whatever version of your music that you are putting online, the people that know you and value the work that you do with your children will also understand that this is not a replacement for in-person lessons. However, this can be a really important and healing stopgap for our children who need to see and hear from the grown-ups that they trust. Okay, now that we have talked about our purpose here, I'm going to walk you through some practical steps to make sure that your video looks and sounds its best to serve your kids the best. So we have gone from our ideal lighting situation to turning everything off except for my overhead fan light. And as you can see, it's not the best. This light is very orange and it's a little dim. The bulbs inside are covered up by the diffusers that normally come on a fan. It's just not the most flattering light. It catches all the lines in the face and it doesn't light up eyes. And that's the most important thing when you're thinking about lighting. You want bright eyes. So I am in a room that is relatively small. It has white walls, and on two of the corners in front of me and to my right, I have windows. So I'm going to show you the difference with one window open. We're going to start off by opening the window in front of me, and already you can see it makes a dramatic difference. So it's catching a little bit more light on my face and on my body. I'm making sure that my camera is close enough to me. We're going for a head and shoulders shot. So now we're going to open up a side light. So this is window light. Window light is beautiful, and window light is free, which is great. So the one thing about window light that's not ideal is that it's unpredictable. You can't control it. So if all you have to work with is window light, that's fine. I would say put your camera right in front of the window, be as close to the window as possible, and film during the brightest time of day. You don't want the light coming directly through the window. You do want it to be indirect. So you don't want to be standing in sunlight. You want to be as close to the edge of the shadow as possible to get great light. So now that we have our window light, we're going to turn on one off-camera light, and there you go. Now we have a catch light in the eyes, and that makes a big difference. Your phone is pretty smart, so when you turn on your phone and you turn on lights and you change the lighting situation, your camera's going to automatically adjust. So you can play with this and you can experiment. I pulled out some lights that we have around the house so that you could see. This is just a normal desk lamp. I like this one for video because before we had the ring light, we would use this all the time. It's got a flexible top so that I could angle it. And again, you're looking for it not to light up your chin, but to light up your eyes. And this is a little bit bright. It's an LED bulb. So we would put a piece of paper or a pillowcase in front of it, and that would be helpful. So the other light that we got to show you is a garage work light. This would work just fine. I would recommend putting it on top of a ladder if you have one. Think about the sun and how it's above you, and when it's behind a nice wispy cloud, outdoor sunlight that's indirect on a person is beautiful. So high and indirect. Just make sure if you are putting a bed sheet or a piece of paper in front of a light like this, these get hot. Don't let them touch. We don't want any fires. So that is, those are notes on lighting. We can add two more lights to this. You can see the difference that two off-camera lights would make. So now I have two diagonal lights, and then we added one directly behind the camera. This is the ideal setup. If you can get a three light situation, it's gonna look professional, but we're trying to get as close to professional as possible with what you have. And again, the most important thing is that it's bright and engaging for your kids. That's what we're looking for. So when we're talking about orientation of the camera, please make sure that you film horizontally. It's so important. When the kids are viewing it on a laptop or an iPad or on their phone, if you put it on YouTube, vertically, then it doesn't fill up the whole screen. And we really want them to be able to look into their music teacher's face and engage with it. So make sure that you are filming horizontally. Let's talk about sound. So this is ideal. Obviously, if we have a clip-on lapel mic, the reason it works best is it's close to my mouth and it's able to eliminate a lot of room noise. This room has four computers, it has hard floors, and it has a lot of external noise going on. So if all you have is your phone, you can still make it work, but you need to get the camera as close to you as you can, because wherever your microphone is, you want it as close to your voice as possible, and you want to eliminate room noise. So make sure that you put those computers to sleep or turn them off, and then to kind of help with the echoing around the room of the hard walls and ceiling and floor, what I recommend is that you get some pillows. Couch cushions work great. So if you're using a phone and propping it up on a music stand, you can get it up pretty decently high, and we all like to see ourselves at eye level or above, and then I would put those couch cushions on the table or as close to your camera as possible. Wherever the microphone is, if you can get those pillows close to the microphone source, then you can deaden the room sound and make your voice heard the most clearly. So you'll be happiest with the sound quality that way. Okay, let's talk about editing. The goal of these videos that we're putting online for our students is not to become amazing online teachers. The goal is to provide comfort and resources for kids in a time of uncertainty. I recommend not editing. Every edit that you make, every splice that you make is going to add 15 minutes to your production time. Don't do it. I do recommend scripting out your lessons and practicing them, because you can only understand when you're behind the camera for the first time how easy it is to start rambling. So keep it short and keep it sweet. Unless your administration has ordered you otherwise, I would say keep these videos to 5 minutes or less. That's enough time to deliver a message of hope to your kids at the beginning, to teach a song, maybe do a brain dance at the end. I'm gonna be giving my kids daily challenges. We're gonna be making maracas out of spoons and Easter eggs. And we're going to be doing different art projects to different time periods of music. Keep them short. Provide resources and provide links. There is no reason for you to reinvent the wheel. There are so many incredible resources within the ORF community. That AOSA online page on Facebook is a great resource, and there are a lot of people posting there. You are welcome to reach out to me if you need anything. me@crystalpridmore.com. I would love to talk to you and help you. And then one more thing I wanted to talk about. I am sure some of you noticed that I have a few things on the table next to me. So this is Fortissimo. He's the star of music class at Finney Elementary. He has a brother, Forte, who only has one F on his belly. And Forte likes to sit with the kids who are singing out using a nice singing voice, but Fortissimo is a little extra. He's extra loud. So he hops around the room, and he is our year-long elf on the shelf. So the little kids like to find him, and it's a really big deal. So I brought Fortissimo home so that Fortissimo can hide in the backdrop backdrop of all of my videos that I'm going to be making for them. And then you probably noticed something that we don't want to have in the background of our videos for music class. And I had that there so that you could see how important it is to make sure that your backdrop is clear. If it's not in your classroom, don't let it be in the background of your video. It's really important that we maintain our image as teachers, and we want that image of the professional, safe grown-up that we have at school, and we don't want any reason for anybody to question it. So check the binding on your books. If you are in front of a bookcase, make sure that every title is appropriate. Make sure that your dirty laundry is not in the background. Make sure that you have nothing on the table that you want the kids to see. Again, just use that common sense of, if I would not bring this to school, it's not going to be in the background of my video. Plain backdrops are the best because they are not distracting. The kids are focused on you. And it's kind of amazing how quickly a video can be screenshotted and turned into a meme. So just be aware of that when you're making these. We have a really powerful opportunity here to be a voice of hope and love for kids who really need it and are probably absorbing a lot of anxiety. And I am proud to be a member of a community that can provide that. And I hope that you feel empowered to go create content and be that for your kids right now. Be well. Be healthy, wash your hands, and we will see each other on the other side of this.